what he was conscious. Yeah. Well, regular one, so even an old continuous conscious, one looks at the durational number to 0-1. Although you can, you know, consider also rational numbers, but let's just take them to be rational just to avoid any additional discussions here. Yeah? And we are asking, when is it possible to expand a number 8 in this form? So what is different here, so I'm allowing this E1, E2, E3 to be also minus 1. Yeah, so they are going to be plus or minus 1. But everything here is rational. And the approximants are going to be rational. So all the digits are going to be integers. Yeah, the A's are positive integers and the E's are plus or minus 1. Yeah. And first we are asking that the A's are even integers. All A's are even integers. And in this case, we talk about even continuous functions. Yeah. In the second case, we ask that all the digits an are both integers, and we also ask that an plus en is at least 2. So I'm not allowing the 1 on this position and the negative 1 on this position, for obvious reasons. But that's only constraint. Yeah, this is only constraint. Right, so in this case, it turns out that every irrational number can be expanded in this way. Yeah? And there are nice dynamical systems associated with this. And they are given exactly by the following Gauss map, Gauss type map, which look like this.
So these are given.
It's just a notation. So these are given in the union of these intervals, so the form 1 over 2k, 1 over 2k minus 1.
Did you even say that every irrational number can be represented?
Yeah, every irrational number, this is a theorem. Every irrational number can be represented in this form.
In each of these forms, right?
In each of these forms, yeah. So there are two different types of continuous functions. It's just that I'm taking them equal, right? So for sake of time, yeah.
Maybe it's unique.
It is, yeah, it is unique. So I think this has not been first up in some work of Rieger, and then has been studied more in detail more recently by.